Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meeking from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to do a crystal nail. So this nail will be crystal clear with, you've guessed it, a bit of bling. So I have already prepped this nail, so I've done the cuticle work and all that shebang. We have the lovely Dina with us today. Don't know much about Dina. I could tell you loads. Shall we start talking about you?
No.
Okay. So I'm going to apply sculpting form. Because we're doing this little like a crystal nail, inspired kind of from, not crystals, more inspired from
icicles.
Icicles!
That was like the worst mime ever.
What was that?
My brain, it was trying to get my brain to engage. What am I talking about? I'm talking about icicles. So this is a very glamorous nail, this is. Very glamorous nail. So we're going to dehydrate. And then we're going to do two coats of primer. Very important to make sure that you remove all the nail. The length of the nail, that is. Not the actual nail. I don't mean like just rip the nail off. We have a video of that. So remove all that length. Make sure your form fits perfectly. This is key. Now we're going to use max adhesion and crystal clear. What I'm going to do is pick up a bead. I am not going to bleed this bead out. I'm going to let it do its thing, and then I'm just going to make sure it butts straight up to that nail and slightly overlaps onto the nail. The less you touch the acrylic, the less bubbles will be in there. So if you think, oh, I want to do a crystal nail, but it's always full of bubbles, maybe you're working it too much. So I'm gently stroking this as well. And also, if you dry your bead out, so if you blot it out onto paper, if you blot that bead out, you will get bubbles as well. So if you want to keep touching it, make sure you've got enough liquid on your brush to be able to just glide over it and not really interfere with the product. Same again, clear bead, let it do its thing, let it start to polymerise, tip the finger down, it's not going to flood anywhere, and then you can gently move it exactly where you want it. The reason that I didn't do one big bead and go straight on is because I would have had to touch the bead so many times, I would have forced bubbles into the bead, and we don't want that. That's why I am sort of doing it in layers, so I've done the free edge first, and now I'm coming here to build up strength, and then I'm going to come here at the back to make that nice and thin, but also overlap, which will give us the apex. So I've done it in three different areas just so I know that everything is controlled and everything's really clear, because it's the clarity that we're after. So same again, pop that bead on, let it do its thing. Drag it over so you can see we're building the apex in the back third now. Just a tiny bead there. So don't touch your bead until it's polymerized. You'll know because it'll go fully shiny. As soon as it's really shiny, you can then start to touch it. And polymerization is where the powder and the liquid come together and it's a chemical reaction. So now I am getting rid of all the bubbles out of my brush. Tap it on the side. I'm just making sure that I have everything laid down, all the structure That's all I'm doing with that last bead. So it's very important to get rid of the bubbles out of your brush. Because if you don't, then they will end up in the acrylic. And we don't want that. It's important if you're doing a crystal nail to make sure that you use fresh monomer, which you should use on every client anyway. But imagine if your dampen dish has got bits of glitter in from previous clients and things like that. Make sure it's really nice and clean, else you will pick that up and you'll transfer it into the acrylic. I'm just going to wait for that to set up a little bit and then I'll pinch. I'm going to pop the pinching tool on. Do a test pinch, let it stay on there for a few seconds and take it off, make sure it's not collapsing anything. And now I'm going to just leave it on there. And I'm going to pinch down the length as well because we want it nice and slim. This will be the last part that starts to set. And I know you're thinking, but you put that on first. I may have put it on first, but it will set last. It'll set at a similar time to this part, but it will set last because there's no heat there. There's no heat from the natural finger. The natural finger? Are all fingers natural? Well, yeah, I suppose some are. Most. So there's no heat from the natural nail in the finger to help it set. So it will set last. So that's why I can still pinch this part. I'm going to take the form off. And there we are, look at that. So you can see it's very clear. And obviously at the minute it looks quite matte because we haven't filed it or shined it or anything like that. So I'm going to use a 180 grit file. This is a straight 180 grit file and we also have a curved 180 grit file. This is better for sidewalls, this is better for around the cuticle area. I am going to take off the sharp edges, very important. So I'm going to run my file down here and here, so flat and then each side. And take off that sharp edge. So as I run my finger down, if I did that for too long, I'd probably get a cut. So I'm going to take that off. This is with all files, you need to take those edges off. So I'm going to use this straight file for these nice straight side walls. So I'm using the curved file now to go around the cuticle area. Make that nice and flush. I'm going to contour the top surface. Now you can use either file to do this, whatever you're comfortable with. You could use a curved file for your sidewalls as well, if you want to. I do slightly prefer the curved file, if I'm honest. And I'm going to buff over to smooth this out now. Now I've got a pink white block. I've got a pink buffer. This is a white block. You know, hence it being white. They're the same grit. One's just pink.
That goes with your hair a bit more, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Your hair's pink at the moment.
Yeah.
But it's more you.
It's more me. So make sure you cover all the curves of the nail. Don't just go, that'll do. Because you want to make sure you remove the demarcations on the nail. So all those little scratches, you need to make sure we get rid of those. I'm going to use a polisher now to shine. We're not going to completely shine this. We're actually just going to smooth it out even more. And I'm doing this because we're doing a crystal nail. So we're doing a clear crystal nail. And I'm going to wipe over with pure acetone. Give that a nice clean. I'm going to whip underneath a little bit as well. And that's just going to smooth it even more as well. I'm going to top coat with the Urban Graffiti top coat because it's a little bit thinner. I don't want to bulk it out or anything yet. I want it shiny before I put stones on. The stones alone will actually bulk it out, so that's why I'm using the Urban Graffiti top coat. I'll pop that in. I'm going to top coat underneath now as well. You can see it's not as shiny as the top surface. So you want to pull the finger back. So basically I'm pulling this skin back, holding that firm. You don't want to touch the skin. Oh, it looks shiny already. Pop it in the lamp. So you're going to pop it in the lamp upside down as well. So you can see that that is really crystal clear now. It's a lot shinier as well. You will always get a very slight, you know, very slight bubbles. But how I applied it will definitely reduce the bubbles down and give you that crystal clear. I'm going to use clear acrylic to adhere the large stones that I'm going to put on. I'm going to take off any of the excess acrylic because it's on a shiny surface. While it's soft, it will just sort of slide off. So you've got to be neat with your application of stones, because you don't want to see all the acrylic everywhere. So if you do this look, and then you make it look messy with too much acrylic while you're adhering your stones, it'll just take away that whole look of it being so clean and crystal-like. I'm going to fill in here with stones, just here, and this part will be completely crystal clear. I'm going to finish this nail. Look at this now, look at all that bling bling bling, and I'm loving how crystal clear it is. And I decided to put a few of the stones on the end just to really exaggerate that we've got a pack of stones here and then this lovely crystal nail, and then the stones on the end really exaggerate the crystal part of the nail. Loving the crystal clear look. Finish with some cuticle oil. There you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed that video of how to do a crystal clear nail inspired by Acrylic, because it's getting cold. It really is. I hope it doesn't snow too soon. Do you know what? That's a lie. I really like snow. I love it. Don't like driving in it, but I love playing in it.
Oh no, all wet and cold.
So don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.